Hello, hello, hello. We are back again. So I wanted to talk about today, I wanted to talk about the magical correspondence between the days of the week. Because a lot of times we do magic, we do spells, we set intentions, we say affirmations, and we don't realize the energy that we're working with for that day, the planets, the herbs, what colors are associated, those types of things. So I'll be going over that today, so get your pens, get your pencils, get your notebooks, because this is important information, especially if you do spell work and things like that. If you work with certain deities, things of that nature, this information would be very helpful for you. So let's get into it. Also, I am doing live personal readings. If you would like a live personal reading, the link is in the description. You will click on it and it will take you to my Hipsy, and I will see it come through, and I will answer your question live, okay? Yeah, you pay and everything over there. Okay, so we're going to start with Sunday. So Sunday, of course, is the planet associated, this planet associated with Sunday is the sun, of course. The colors are yellow and gold. The plants are sunflower and marigold. The stones are diamond, amber, tiger's eye, carnelian, sunstone, topaz, and gold. There are herbs that are associated with Sunday. Those herbs are cedar, frankincense, lemon, and St. John's wort. Okay? You can get a summer solstice abundance oil to help you with any spell work or anything that you may be doing. Okay? The food associated with Sunday is the orange. The gods and goddesses is Brigid, Helios, Apollo, Lug, Bel or Bel, B-E-L-L or B-E-L. Okay. Sunday is the first day of the week, perfect for new beginnings. This day rules the conscious element of the human mind, the ego, and the real self. It is the confidence, your strength, your resilience, your personal power. The sun is life-giving and it's energetic. It inspires growth and accomplishment. Spells and rituals that you can do on Sundays include exorcisms, healings, prosperity, individuality, hope, fortune, work, power, promotion, strength, spirituality, swift change, and God rituals. And when I say God rituals, I mean that's connecting to like that God sense, that Christ consciousness. Okay. Some simple Sunday spells are getting your sweat on, feeling the heat in your body rise. Marvel at your strength and focus on strength, strength onto your goal you want to accomplish. Focusing on the strength that you want to accomplish in your goals, in your achievements, in your work, in your home, in your relationships. Whatever goals that you have in mind, you want to focus on the strength on that. Plant a seed with the intention to, with intention, and place it at the east facing window. As your plant grows, so will your intention begin to manifest. Also, you can prepare a cup of coffee or tea and sip it while watching the sunrise. Feel yourself become energized and ready to take on the day. These will help you connect with the energy of Sunday. Any one of these or all of them are great suggestions to hone in on the energy of Sunday. Okay. the next day, which is today, which is Monday. The planet is the moon. The color is white, silver, and blue. I got my moon day colors on. The plants are bluebells, jasmines, gardenias, and white roses. The crystal or stone would be moonstone and pearl. The herbs would be jasmine, lemon, sandalwood, honeysuckle, myrtle, willow, and wormwood. Oils, you can use a lunar goddess oil, or some type of moon oil or moon incense, that will help you stand in that energy of the moon. You might also want to burn maybe a pink one for self-love, even though it's not in the white, blue, silver, but I'm kind of feeling like, as an intuitive, the moon energy is all about that self-love, okay? The gods and goddesses that you would want to invoke or use on a Monday would be Selene, Luna, Diana, Armedius, and Thoth. The food is melon, so cantaloupes, watermelon, honeydew melon. Any type of melon would be good, and you can use those as an offering to those deities that I just mentioned. Mondays are ruled by the moon and the divine feminine energy that its celestial body is associated with. The cycle of the moon has long been associated with the menstrual cycle. So your menstrual cycle could be, you might notice that your menstrual cycle links up with the full moon, new moon phases. Also, the heaviness of your flow depending on the phase of the moon. Okay, therefore it is an excellent planet to work with for fertility, transformation, and change. Okay, the moon rules the realm of the subconscious. This is where we access our emotions, our intuition, and our psychic gifts. You would do well to perform divination or shadow work on this day. So today is a good day to do shadow work. Today is a good day to do, you know, psychic types of gifts. Workings, like developing your psychic intuition, clearing your third eye, strengthening your third eye, your crown chakra, okay? Spells and rituals that you can that involve agriculture, animals, feminine energy, messages, reconciliation, theft, voyages, dreams, emotions, clairvoyance, home, family, medicine, cooking, personality, merchandising, psychic work, fae work or fairy work, and goddess rituals. So that's the crone mother. Crone mother and I can't think of the other one. The maiden, the crone, and the mother. That's it. Magic Mondays, spells that you could do is drink a soothing cup of chamomile tea with the intentions to have prophetic dreams that night. Call upon your goddess Selene when performing and participating or practicing tarot for increase in your intuition. Write down your grievances on toilet paper or a natural-based paper and flush it down the toilet and send it away in a body of water. That is a great cord-cutting ritual to write it on the toilet paper, your grievances, anything that you may be feeling down about or have or feel like you know, it's weighing on you, any type of grievance, any type of something someone's done wrong to you, any type of betrayal, anything like that, write it down on flushable paper and put your intentions, all of your energy into it and flush it. It's a great cord cutting ritual. Okay, so Tuesday is ruled by Mars. The colors are scarlet, black, red, and orange. The plants are snapdragon, thistle, and holly. The stones are garnet and bloodstone. Garnet is the Capricorn birthstone. The herbs are basil, ginger, black pepper, and dragon's blood and patchouli. You might want to get you some dragon's blood oil to do in your workings or your spells or your incantations or your script papers that you burn. And the foods associated with Tuesday are carrots, peppers, and garlic. Tuesday is ruled by the planet of Mars, who is associated with the Roman god of war, Ares, okay? And this day is also the perfect day for any areas in your life that require strength, courage, and speed. So if you're requiring, if you have a project that needs to be done and you need it done quickly, you need it done efficiently, you need to have the courage to proceed with it, Tuesday would be a great day to do that type of spell work or work on those type of intentions. Tuesday is also great for boosting your energetic shield to guide yourself from jumping into action. To guard yourself from jumping into action. So this is so that you take that time before you are reactive to really think about the processes as it goes. Is it worth it? What are the outcomes? Things of that nature. Okay. Spells and rituals that involve courage, physical strength, revenge, military honors, surgery, the breaking of negative spells, dynamic energy, matrimony, war, enemies, prison, hunting, politics, contest, protection, victory, and athletics. So anything that has to do with any of those things, Tuesday is a great day to do those types of spells. So trusty Tuesday spells that you can try on the practical level is take a ritual bath with Epsom salts and garnet and dragon's blood oil to cleanse yourself and boost your protection shield and armor up. So those of you that are looking for a good protection ritual bath, that's a good one. Epsom salt, garnet, and dragon's blood essential oils or oil in the bath will boost your protection and put your shields up so that you are guarded and protected against any type of negative energy that may be coming towards you. You can start your day with a hearty omelet with peppers and garlic to strengthen you throughout your day. So this is to give you an all-day boost of strength and protection. Garlic and peppers are very good to use on Tuesdays. I think they're one of the plants. They are one of the foods that can be invoked to use the energy of Tuesday. Okay? You can wear red, orange, black, or use color magic to boost your confidence and bring courage into your day. So by wearing the colors, like today is Monday, so I'm wearing blue and white. So I am invoking and calling in that energy of the moon and of Monday. So you can do the same thing with Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Any other days, you can wear the colors and do color magic, okay? You can also harness the fiery energy that a cord cutting ceremony can embrace. Now, I just told you how to do a cord cutting ceremony bath, but you can also do it with candle magic as well. You get a white candle, a black candle and a white candle. You tie a string between the two. You put all of your negativity, all of the darkness, any toxicity, anything that you're looking to get rid of, people, places, things, ideologies, whatever it may look like, you pour all of that energy into your black candle. The white candle is going to be the releasing, the cleansing, the purifying of that energy. So what you would do is you would light a match or a piece of wood like so to light the string. Once you light the string, it should burn away on each side. As that burns, you would say the incantation, as this burns, you know, I release all negative energy. I release this person. I release whatever it is you're trying to release. You know, you would pour that into that and you would hold that energy. You would hold that vision. And as it burns down, your negativity will leave you. Whatever it is that you're trying to cut your cord from will leave you. The white candle will bring in that peace, that harmony. Excuse me. That peace, that harmony, that clarity that is needed to move on so that you are no longer attached to these things that have been holding you down in the past. Okay? Let's see here. Boom, 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 boom. So we have Wednesday. Wednesday is ruled by the planet Mercury. The color is purple and orange. The plants are fern, lavender, lily of the valley, and aspen. The stones are citrine. Any type of agates, you know, they have black agates, red agates, multicolor agates. They have all different types of agates, so whatever one you feel drawn to. Aventrine, mica, pumice, quicksilver, and zinc. The herbs are lavender, eucalyptus, jasmine, and sweet pea. You might want to try a tranquility oil that may help you or make your own. There are plenty of recipes online as to make of how to make certain types of spiritual oils, tranquility oils, financial stability oil, which I do make the oils as well if you need those. You can order them. Just hit me up on Facebook or IG. Just hit me, slide in my DMs or my IMs, and I'll give you the way to order those. Excuse me. The gods and goddesses for Wednesday is Odin, Athena, and Hermes. Wednesday is ruled by the planet of Mercury, making it the perfect day for communication. If there's a conflict that needs addressing, a big decision to discuss, a promotion you want to ask your boss for, or any other situation where communication will be used as a sword, this is the day to harness that magic. That would be on a Wednesday. Wednesday is great for communications. It's great to do communication spells. It's great to do a spell to call your power back or to get your voice back. Some of you need to speak up for yourselves. Wednesdays is a good day to tap into that energy of communication. Spells and rituals that involve the conscious mind, study, travel, divination, and wisdom are great to do on Wednesdays. Some working Wednesday rituals or spells you can do. You can carry an agate stone in your pocket to help you face any unexpected obstacles that may come up in your path throughout that day. You have, if you have a decision to make on a Wednesday, it is a perfect day to do a pros and cons list. Burn a blue candle for clarity while doing while writing out your pros and cons list. That while you're burning the candle, this will help you embody the energy of communication, okay, and clarity. You can gargle with salt water and apply lavender oil to your throat to help you speak more effectively. This is helping you pronunciate. This is helping you get your point across. This is if you're nervous public speaker, this will also help you calm your nerves as far as delivering your speech or whatever it is in front of a lot of people, okay? You can also do a consciousness communication to start your day, which would be like a tea ceremony. So this would be you speaking over your tea or your coffee, the intentions that you want to have for conscious communication for that day. You can charge, by the way, FYI, here's the skinny. You can charge anything that you drink, your juice, your water, your soda, your coffee, your tea, your liquor. Liquor is a spirit. So you can program and charge all of these things. And by doing so, you are ingesting your incantation or your affirmation or the energy that it is that you're trying to embody. You are ingesting it, which means that that water or that liquid is it is integrating with the 70% of the water that is already in our body. So it is changing literally the molecular cellular structure of the water in your body when you speak over your drinks, okay? The next way, Thursday. Thursday is ruled by Jupiter. Jupiter is all about expansion. It's all about abundance. It's all about the bigger is better type energy. Okay, so it is ruled by the planet of Jupiter. The colors are blue, purple, and green. The plants are oats and wheat. The stones are amethyst, labradorite, shungalite, and tin. The herbs, clove, oat moss, cinnamon, musk, nutmeg, and sage. The oils, you might want to try a manifestation oil. Again, you can do things like use peppermint oil and put it in a base carrier oil and make your own roll-ons. Peppermint is all about abundance as well. Rosemary, you can use that as well. Cloves, cinnamon, allspice, nutmeg. All of these herbs are for prosperity, abundance, success, those types of things, okay? Sage is protective, okay? The gods for Thursday are Thor, Jupiter, Zeus, Taranis, Perkanus. Okay? Thursday is ruled by the planet of Jupiter, which is associated with the Norse and the Norse god Thor and the Roman god Jupiter. Jupiter is the largest planet and therefore is also the most powerful. That's why when we call in Leo Lionsgate energy, we're calling in big Jupiter energy. Okay? Thursday is the best day to perform manifesting magic. Prepare your money magic. Ask for a raise. Have fun with friends and loved ones. Spells and rituals include luck, happiness, health, legal matters, male fertility, treasure, health. I don't know why folks are calling me. No. Health, treasure, honors, riches, clothing, money, desires, business, group pursuits, joy, laughter, and expansion. Remember, when you think Jupiter, think expansion. It's the big planet. It's the biggest planet, and it's a gas planet. Okay? Bigger, more powerful. Big energy. Thrifty Thursday spells. You can write down what you manifest on a bay leaf and burn it. Bay leaves are very conductive as to when you write down your intention on it and you burn it, it's very conducive. Things happen, okay? Start your morning with a slice of wheat toast. Add butter or your choice of spread in the form of a dollar sign and feel the abundance and prosperity entering your life. This again is eating and drinking to embody the energy that you're trying to visualize or hold or have come into fruition. Okay? Have a meal with good friends and family, laugh a lot, and feel how abundant life is with your love. With your loved ones and your friends that you have. This is also taking in that time to really like do that thing where you are giving love and receiving love, right? You're in this thing of unconditional gratitude and love for your friends, your families, your colleagues, those people that are close to you, your circle, right? Your people. You can also do a ritual to work some money magic with any type of ancestral money drawing oil, or you can get money drawing oil, you know, and do some spell work to draw that in. Maybe you can do you a money bowl and drizzle some of that around. Maybe you could do you a money tree. Anything that has to do with money is great to do on Thursday for the energy of Jupiter, that expansion, that success, that luck, that wealth, that treasure, finding new avenues and becoming more resourceful as well. You can also do spells to make yourself a money magnet, meaning that resources are going to find you, ideas are going to find you, a strategy is going to come to you to make you more successful in your endeavors. All right, moving along. Friday. Friday is ruled by Venus. Venus is also good for attraction and money. So Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, even Mondays you can do money spells on, because that is still Venus energy. Even though it's moon energy, it is also Venus energy, and Venus is all about attraction. Even though it's beauty and things of that nature, it's in love, it's also about attraction. You do not have to be a devotee. You just have to love yourself enough to believe that you deserve the attraction that you want, whether it's money or a partner, okay? So Friday is ruled by Venus. The colors are pink and aqua. The plant is rose, okay? The stones are rose quartz, jade, lapis lazuli, coral, emerald, malachite, and copper. So Fridays, those are stones that you could use to do some money magic or abundance magic, things like that. You can use herbs such as rose, yarrow, cardamom, strawberry, sandalwood, saffron, and vanilla. Also, thyme is good as well. You can use love and attraction oil to bring in, like I said, either money or a partner. Okay, the gods and goddesses that you would want to work or invoke would be Eros, Venus, Aphrodite, and Freya. Foods would be strawberries. You could also use pomegranates and chocolate, okay? Friday is ruled by Venus. It is a day that is usually associated with reward and relaxation due to the end of the work week. But the influence is also due to the celestial body that it governs, which is Venus, okay? Friday is good for indulging. It's a date night. It's a nice day for to have a luxurious bath and a glass of wine. Set the ambiance, light some candles, throw some essential oils in your bath. You know, really do some self-love care here. It's time to celebrate and have some free time, okay? Take that time to do a self-love ritual. You can do a love or romantic ritual, a ritual that has to do with marriage, your partner, anything that has to do with a sexual matter, physical beauty, partnerships, friendships, social activities, strangers, pleasure, music, incense, perfumes, nature, the arts and crafts. So if you're one of those DIY people and you're into arts and crafts, Fridays are a great day to like immerse yourself and flow in your creative energy of creating art, making crafts, making music, whatever it is that you do. Fridays are a good day to immerse yourself in what it is that you do. Whatever it is your talent is, whether it's singing, whether it's dancing, whether it's making something, whether it's drawing something, whether it's art, whether it's sculpting, whether it's making perfumes, whether it's making incense. Like I make whipped shea butters and oils and things like that. I'm very much the DIY person. So Fridays are a great day for me to make my baskets, make my butters, make my scrubs, make my oils, make my roll-ons, do things like that. Do money magic, make me a money bowl, bring some roses and offerings for Venus, you know what I mean? A glass of wine, a nice glass of red wine, some pomegranate seeds, arrows, some chocolate, bring something that smells good, some strawberries, things like that. These are offerings that you can give while you do these rituals. You can combine more than one element to boost the energy of that day and to boost the magic of your spell for that day. Okay? And last but not least, we have Saturday, which is ruled by Saturn, okay? The colors are black and deep purple. The plants are pansies, morning glories and cypresses. Okay. What else? The stones are obsidian, hematite, jet, coral, salt, lead, serpentine, and pewter. The herbs are cypress, myrrh, patchouli, black poppy seeds, and mullein. Mullein is also very good if you have like respiratory issues, you have problems with breathing, COPD, things like that. You can drink mullein tea or even inhale the mullein smoke and it will open up those airways for you, okay? You can use Hijon oil. Where is it? Here it is. You can see I use a lot of Hijon oil. It is almost gone, but it is good to use on Saturdays. The gods and goddesses that you will want to work with on Saturdays is Hecate, Cerate, Saturn, Kronos, and the Norns, and Loki. Now, Loki can also be known as a trickster. So be careful, okay? Saturday is ruled by Saturn, the planet of time, karma, and self-discipline. The systems that are in place to help you live the best life you can. It is also an excellent day to begin to break habits. So it takes anywhere from 21 to 30 days to break any habit. So if you want to quit smoking for 21 to 30 days, you will break the habit. Any habit that you have, any thought that you have, any ideas that you have, anything that you are trying to break, 21 to 30 days of consistent work and you will break that habit, okay? And it is the ideal day to clean up any messes. So do your spring cleaning, clean your house, wipe your floors, wash your dishes, do your clothes, get rid of clutter, declutter your space. Okay, great day to do that, Saturday, okay? Whether it's physical or energetic cleansing that needs to be done. So if you need to take a spiritual bath, anything like that, okay? So that you can start your week off with a clean slate. So some of you, this would be a good idea to actually make it part of your Saturday ritual to do a little bit of energetic and physical cleaning so that you can start your work week off with a clean slate, clean energy, so that you're not bombarded with clutter, okay? Whether this is energetic clutter, mental clutter, emotional clutter, whatever it is, financial clutter as well, because some of us have bad spending habits and we don't understand why we don't ever have no money. And you don't have money because you have bad spending habits. I'm just saying. Maybe you need to do something for that too, because it is about structure. That's for somebody out there, okay? It's also a day to create plans, write down your goals, evaluate aspects of your life to decide what is working and what needs to be altered. If you work a 9-to-5 job, then this is the time for you and you alone. Take that me time. Take that relaxation time. If you work Monday through Friday, Saturday is your day. Saturday and Sunday is your day to relax, to take some time for yourself, to choose to dedicate small portion of your day to improving your life. Do things that are going to help you improve your life, whether they are small internal actions or external actions, physical or energetic is what I'm saying. Okay? Rituals that are spells that you can do on Saturdays. What happened to my little stick I had? That is so disappointing. I like that. It was giving me, I don't know, it was giving me wand. All right, well, we'll just use the selenite wand. The spiritual spells and rituals that you could be doing on Saturday are spirit work, communication work, meditation, psychic attack or defense work, locating a lost item or missing person, self-discipline, life building, doctrine, things of removing certain doctrines out of your life, ideologies, things like that, programming, things like that, protection, freedom, things that have to do with the elderly, destroying disease and pests, crystallization, hidden or obscure matters, limitations and boundaries. So some of you need to set limitations and boundaries. Some of you need to let go of some limitations and boundaries. Saturday is a great day for that. Again, it is ruled by Saturn, which is all about course correction, discipline, getting your shit together, getting things in alignment, letting go of things that no longer serve you so that you can communicate clearly to the universe what direction you want to go in. Okay? Solution Saturday spells. Okay. For Saturday, you can write a list of what you are grateful for the week that you have experienced and attract more of that yummy energy into your life for the week to come. While writing it down, it connects you with the energy. You get to see it. You're writing it. You're reading it. All of that energy is getting recycled back into your subconscious mind. So therefore, you're reinforcing it as you're writing it, as you're seeing it, okay, as you're saying it. So that energy will start to be embodied within you and anchored within you, and you can start to use that as a jump off point. Like if you're not having such a good day, you could think about all of the things that you are grateful for, and that will put you in a place of appreciation and acceptance. Okay? You can do a 3-card tarot reading if you're into that, or you can book one of my services and get a 3-card tarot reading of what area of your life you need to reevaluate, or how is it affecting your life and how you can move about altering things in your life. Okay, 3 cards, past, present, future, mind, body, spirit, internal, external, and beyond, whatever, we can do it. House, planet, zodiac, 3-card spreads, I got you. Okay, or you can perform some magical cleansing by sweeping your home and smudging to dispel any old energy and invite new energy in. You can smudge and mop your floors with mop water. You can put a bay leaf in there. You can add a little bit of cinnamon in there. You can use some Florida water, things like that to cleanse it. Put in cleansing herbs that will, a little bit of rosemary, things like that to charge your water. And as you are putting these things or getting your mop water together, you can be consecrating it, enchanting it, if you will, to cleanse your home of any negativity, of any darkness, of anything that is stagnant, that it may be an obstacle in bringing in positive energy into your home. Okay. And you can charge it with those intentions. Be specific. When you guys make your intentions, you guys are not being specific enough. Be specific. Go off, go down the rabbit hole. Feel it. See it. Taste it. You know, use all of your extrasensory and your multisensory and your 5-sensory abilities to manifest what it is that you want. Okay? No matter the seasons, the time, the day, the lunar cycles, the lunar cycle can be performed at any type of magic, performs the magic, right? If you are one of those witches that need big spell work to get to feel like you're doing something, think about this. The little ones build up, practice makes perfect. So you can't just say that you want to jump off and do a big spell and then you wonder why it doesn't turn out the way you want. Practice makes perfect. I suggest you do a little spell every day. Use a little bit of each of the elements that I gave you. Do some color magic. Do some herbal magic. Use some essential oils. Do some crystal magic. You know, do a spiritual bath. Write down some incantations. Get you a spell book, aka a grimoire. Write down the day of the week. Write down the materials that you use. Write down your intentions, your manifestation, or your consecration, whatever it is. Write it down. Write down everything that you used. Write down the emotions that you had. Write down everything that you were feeling for that spell for that day. And then go back at the end of the week or in a couple of days and see if you noticed any, if your spell worked. Write down your findings, your results. You have to think of it as an experiment, but it's a witchy experiment, okay? And I digress. So if you guys are interested in booking any of my live services or recorded services, you can book me on hipsy.com/ Black Moon Goddess Intuition. When I'm online like I am now, you are able to go on to the website and click the four services that I offer while I am live. There are more services available that are recorded that you can also purchase on Hipsy, and I will get back to you within 24 to 48 hours. If you have an emergency, I do have emergency service that means that you will receive a message within anywhere from two hours to 24 hours. I think that's it. If you are interested in the whipped shea butters or the whipped shea butters, they come in colors, scents, glitter butter, shimmer butters, or plain. The scrubs are salt scrubs, sugar scrubs, salt and sugar scrubs, or a crystal sand scrub. Some of them, I do have crystal butters where there is a crystal inside, literally, or a crystal scrub where the crystal is inside, literally. The scrubs can be plain, which would be a plain pink Himalayan sea salt scrub, a plain sea salt scrub, or a plain sugarcane scrub, okay? They do come in scents, colors, and effects, so you can get you a shimmer one, a glitter one, things like that. I use my abundance body salt. It's a salt, sugar, and sand scrub that I made. I use that today. My skin feels amazing. And I'm trying to figure out where I get this scratch from. And I also use my butter on my tattoo. If you can see, it is healing very well. I did not have any peeling or scabbing or any of that. So get at your girl. When I say my products are the bomb diggy from head to toe, the oil, the hair oil that I make, you can use it on your hair, your skin, and your skin. The butter that I make, you can use it on your hair and your skin. The scrubs that I make, you can use it on your face, your lips, and your body. So everything for everybody in the family, okay? If you have eczema, get the plain one. It's great for eczema. It's great for alopecia. It's great for bug bites, scars, blemishes, anything like that. Get at your girl, okay? Get at your girl. When I say it works, it works, okay? It works. So I thank you guys for joining me. I really appreciate your time, your support, and everything. Be sure to hit that Hipsy link or hit the link for Black Moon Goddess Intuition. There's the book button, the Facebook page. You can hit the book button there. It will go to my calendar, or you can set up an account on my PaperBell and you can choose out of the options there. PaperBell does have, is where you would get the coaching sessions, because I am a certified spiritual transformation coach. I call myself a catalyst because I'm not really coaching you. I'm just giving you another way to look at your situation, look at yourself, and better yourself and become more authentic in your life, okay? All right, guys. I'm going to go ahead and start editing and doing my good stuff. You guys have a great and wonderful day. You remember, as above, so below, as within, so without. Nobody booked a personal reading while I was live. That is fine. You don't have to book while I'm live. I do have services offered while I am offline. So just still use that Hipsy link. That is the best way to book a service, or through the Facebook page, or through the Paperbell. So there's three ways to book. Facebook, Black Moon Goddess Intuition, hit the book button. Paperbell, make an account, book a service. Hipsy, go to the recorded sessions, unless I'm on live. If I'm on live, I can do your reading while I am live. Go to Hipsy and book your session while I'm live, and I will do it live for you. If you catch me on the replay or when I'm not on live, then it will be recorded, okay? And you would get it within that day for the most part, all right? So I thank you. I love you for your love, your guide, your love and your support. I thank you very much. And yeah, make your orders, order your shea butters, your scrubs, your hair oils, your protection oils, your smudge sprays, all of that good stuff, all handmade. And yes, I do charge them in the moon too. So a lot of batches will be moonlit charged, will be charged from the full moon. Yeah. So I guess that's it. I thank you guys. As above, so below. As within, so without. Be blessed.